Lord, I pray, I thank you, Lord. I thank you that you've given us your word, that you say that we are not children of darkness, that we are children of the light, that we won't be caught off guard for that day to surprise us, but we will see that day approaching, and that we should encourage one another. So, Lord, that's what we seek to do here, is we seek to be about your work, Father. Lord, your word says that we don't know exactly the day or hour that you're showing up, but you want us to be faithful servants, giving food at the proper time, being diligent to work on your business, in your house, until you come. Help us to be faithful. Lord, help us to do what you are calling us to do and to stand at the gates and watch for you every moment, every second of every day, so that when you show up, we're watching for you and we're doing our jobs, Lord. Thank you, God, that we can work in the field, that we can plant seeds for the harvest, God. Lord, we know that it is all by your Holy Spirit, Lord. It is not us, Lord. It is you who produce the harvest. It is you who you prepare the soil. You convict the heart through your Holy Spirit. You make the produce grow. You make the seed grow, Lord. We know it's all by your Holy Spirit. We are just called to be present and to be servants and obedient to what you would have us do, Lord. So I pray that you would help us to be obedient. Help us to speak. Help us to be bold now to share the Lord, Father, with people around us, God. We know that time is short. And so, Lord, I pray that you would help us speak in love, speak truth in love to those around us. Help us to be fearless. Help us to be creative on how we can share the gospel and reach people. Lord, I just pray that you would bless the seeds that we're planting, preserve them. Again, hide them from the evil one, hide them from the devourer. Lord, we pray that you would rebuke the devourer on our behalf, so that what we are storing and leaving would be found by those who need it, that can produce a harvest for the kingdom of God. And Lord, we pray for the hearts of those in our lives who are lost and who are asleep in Sodom, God. Lord, we know that your word says that the day of your coming will be like the days of Lot and the days of Noah. And truly, Lord, that is where we are at now. Lord, we see that we are in Sodom and Gomorrah, that evil is good and good is evil. Lawlessness abounds, Lord. So, Lord, we just pray like Abraham prayed for Lot and for those in Sodom. God, we pray that you would send your spirit, that you would send your messenger to grab hold of those who are, we love, our family, our friends who are asleep in Sodom. Grab hold of their hearts, Father, and pull them out before the judgment comes, God, before the fire and the brimstone and in the time of your wrath comes, Lord. Lord, we pray that you would convict their hearts, bring them to whatever they need to be brought to, whether it's they need to be brought low and hit rock bottom, or whether they need to be blessed beyond their wildest imagination and your kindness and love breaks through their hearts, their hard hearts. Lord, we pray that you would remove the scales off of eyes, that you would let your word pierce, like it says in your scripture, to dividing bone and marrow, soul and spirit. God, everything is open and laid bare before you, to whom we must give account. Lord, we know that man is not our judge, but you are our judge, Lord. And God, we just pray that you would help us to speak your word, share your word, because faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. And Lord, we know that we are saved through faith, by grace through faith in you, not of anything we've done, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for that. So God, I pray for our family. I pray for those who are lost. I pray for our neighbors, our coworkers, our aunts and uncles, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, children. Lord, I pray that you would reach them. And Lord, if they have hardened their heart and they don't hear you before the wedding feast, before the rapture, and they find themselves in the tribulation, Lord, I pray that you would bring to their remembrance, God, by your Holy Spirit, Bring to their remembrance the words that were spoken to them, the seeds that we have planted by your word. Lord, I pray that you would bring to their remembrance that it was Jesus Christ who foretold these things, that it was Jesus Christ who raptured his church off of this earth, that it is Jesus Christ who is the only way to heaven and the only way by which you receive eternal life. Lord, I pray that you would bring to their remembrance these things, and that you would protect them from the strong delusion and the lie that is coming to deceive those who dwell on the earth. Lord, we rebuke that. We pray against that in Jesus' name on their behalf. We ask for mercy, just as Abraham did on their behalf, God. We know that we are children of Abraham because we are children of the faith, because it was righteousness was accounted to Abraham because of faith, Lord. And we are children of faith. And we are righteous because of our faith in you, because you have washed us clean in your blood by the blood of the Lamb, by Jesus Christ. So, Lord, we have faith. And, Lord, we plead as Abraham pled on their behalf, God, that you would have mercy on them, that you would protect them from the lie and bring to their remembrance the words and the seeds that were spoken and the seeds that were planted. Help them to understand that Jesus Christ is the answer, and that every answer they need is in your word. God, thank you for this time. Thank you for your word. Thank you that we can see what is coming, that we are not caught off guard. Thank you that you give us this opportunity, these last moments, to prepare and to leave behind seeds that can produce a harvest even after we are gone. Thank you, Lord, that those who are in the tribulation are not without hope, but that they can still choose you and receive eternal life. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your mercy, for your long suffering. God, we know that many of us are tired and weary from running the race, Lord, but we know your word says that you will not delay too long. Though it seem like you delay, you won't delay. You are perfect in your timing. You are perfect in your timing, God. You're going to come exactly when you need to and when you mean to. Thank you, Lord. Help us to have patient endurance, as your word says. Thank you that your word says you are going to keep us from that hour of trial that is coming on this whole earth. Thank you that you have prepared a place for us so that where you are, we may be also, Lord. We look forward to that blessed hope, Father, as it says in Titus 2:13. We look forward to your glorious appearing. We pray this in Jesus' mighty name, and we say, Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. Amen.